Friends, we move into the next academic session. This session is being chaired by Unmesh Dixit, Vice President West of the Public Relations Society of India. Unmesh ji, can we have you up here? Shri Unmesh Dixit, are you here? Unmesh Dixit is a highly innovative, relation-oriented, strong PR and demonstrated success in increasing value addition work, achieving cost reductions and improving employee satisfaction in operations in large, diverse organizations. He has expertise in education, PR, HR management and the implementation of complex corporate initiatives and successful organizational integration. He is currently being a CEO of Sri Bhagavat Vidyapit Trust, has been an instrument for image building and growth of the trust over the last 3 years, and he is highly competent professional, worked with Zydus Cadila as a corporate HR manager, most stable and able PR manager for Kellogg Foundation, where he worked for 12 years almost and handled 12 different locations, schools for establishment, growth and resolved most complex problems in the history of the entire institute. With him on the panel, we have Sagar Daryani, co-founder and chief executive officer of Wow Momo. Can we have you up here, Sagar? Sagar, are you here? Is Sagar Daryani here? Huh? What? Yeah, he should be here. This is his session. Can someone fetch Sagar Daryani for us, please? And of course, Tarun Mullick, Managing Director, Club International, is founder of Club International Private Limited, ex-junior Bengal champion in table tennis and national rank holder, looks after the production of overall business operations. Mullick has conducted several entrepreneurship development programs till date for the National Center for Jute Diversification and National Jute Board, Ministry of Textiles. So friends, we have the MD of Club International here, Tarun Mullick. Can I introduce, is Sagar here? Has he arrived? So what I'll do is I will talk about Sagar. As and when he arrives, he will join us here on stage. Sagar is the co-founder and CEO of Wow Momo. As you know, that's a very well-known chain of fast food restaurants based primarily here in Kolkata, specializing in momos, very popular dumpling here, Tibet and in Nepal. He was established in 2008 by him and Vinod Homagai. The brand has literally played with momos to have grown rapidly to become the country's largest momo chain in terms of volumes, turnovers and innovations. Their menu caters to 12 different flavors of momos, available in various formats, largely in white and brown flour variants. So, Sagar, as and when he comes, will join us here on the panel. And may I request the session chair, Unmesh Dixit, to start the proceedings, please.
Good afternoon, everybody. We will wait for Mr. Sagar, but by that time, since we are running short of time also, would straight away request Mr. Tarun to share his views, his academic insight related to the conference and the theme. You may please go there.
Respected person, distinguished guest, ladies and gentlemen. First of all, I would like to tell you, in our country, as per McKinsey report, there are 55 crore people are going to be unemployed by 2020. Out of that, majority is educated, graduate and above. we evade or escape the responsibility of tomorrow, because more organization is happening in India than industrialization. If you see, even top Indian branded product are made in Cambodia, made in Vietnam, made in China. Forget about multinational brand. If people like you and me become job seeker, then who will be the job creator? Then what is the solution? Solution is sustain and grow a small enterprise and develop more and more micro and small entrepreneur. Because entrepreneurship have the power to lift people out of poverty and solve unemployment problem. The venture may be small, but the employment is huge. The non-corporate small business are the backbone of the economy and the largest contributor to urban and rural employment. The 45% contribution to national GDP and compared to 15% by the corporate sector. Again, I'm repeating, their 45% contribution, the society sector, to national GDP and compared to 15% by the corporate sector. They provide 90% of employment in the country. Out of that, 46 crore employed, 24 crore self-employed. But most interesting part is the exercise sector mostly employ those who doesn't get job in the government department or corporate sector. They arrange the capital needed mostly on their own and spring up to meet the needs. What you call today's time is bootstrap entrepreneur. In a country like us, that we need to generate 1 crore jobs a year, nurturing this business is a sure way of addressing the requirement. Despite generating a value addition additionals of 6.28 lakh crore per annum, only less than 4% of the sector financial needs are served by banks. To become a small entrepreneur, capital doesn't matter. People say, to start any venture, you need a lot of capital. And there are a lot of risks. I tell you, to become a small entrepreneur, capital doesn't matter, and no risks at all. Just need common sense to get a futuristic idea. What is futuristic idea? Which is logically correct, commercially viable, and it has to be different than others. Also, you must know how to place artistically and aesthetically. Then there are no what called risks. What is risks? If you know what you are doing, it is never a risk. If you don't know what you are doing, it is always a risk. Like I tell you, I'm a former swimming family. My uncle was an Olympian, elder brothers were Indian record holder. I was also state level swimmer in under 12 and all. So if I go to any swimming pool and if I drive on the pool, I'll have no problem. If I go to Sundarban and drive on the river, so I might have problem because alligator is there. So I must know what I am doing. If you know what we are doing, it is never a risk at all. Knowledge is capital. Knowledge capital is ultimate capital. Financial capital is not at all capital. Don't forget, world is knowledge driven with technology base, and imagination is more important than knowledge, because knowledge is limited, but imagination encircles the world. That is why I say, businessman can fail, entrepreneur never fail. Thank you. Businessman can fail, but entrepreneur never fail. Actually, difference is mentally and attitude. You will get lots of businessmen, but unfortunately, you can get hardly entrepreneur. To become a small entrepreneur, you just need 3 things. Product, contacts, and finance. If you have out of these 3, 2, third automatics comes. If you have product, if you have contacts, finance automatics comes. If you have contacts, if you have finance, product automatics comes. If you have product, if you have finance, contacts automatic comes. I tell you, if anybody want to start his venture, and after acquiring two, and I will decide you have acquired two or not. If he failed, I'm responsible for entire losses. He cannot fail. If he acquired two, then if he go for entrepreneurship, he will never fail. For small entrepreneur, public relation is more essential to start, sustain, and grow. With, I think here, PRSI can play a major role to the SSI sector to help. It should be taken a special care for Public Relations Society of India, because I'm also benefited from a PRO, individual level, not in PR society, but now PR system is different. That's why we are here today, otherwise not. I don't mind to mention his name. His name is Gopinath Ghosh, because I was in table tennis, so he used to help me because of table tennis. That is not for PR. Because everywhere is who is whose and who are you. This concept goes everywhere. Otherwise, you cannot start your venture, you cannot sustain your venture, you cannot grow your venture. Marketing ultimate build the leader. There are two types of marketing. One is inept way, one is innovative way. The inept way means inefficient way, I mean to say, like one product is free with another, huge discount, 60%, 70%, this, that. I tell you, after GST implemented once, you cannot do all these things. Because as per GST law, whatever you get discount, whatever price you saw, you have to pay the full duty on that particular product. Like I tell you, in Flipkart discount concept, we are, last few days before, we have won the Flipkart National Award, the first 100 sellers. But I have seen, they asked me, without giving the discount, how you sell so much. Their marketing director called me and they told me. I said, I give discount throughout the year. Why should I give for your big billion day and all this thing? I don't require to give it because I'm manufacturer. Whatever I manufacture, I sell that product only. I don't sell anything, trading or something. I'm taking a product, someone, and I'm selling. Product is ultimate innovation, because I believe marketing is few words. I don't believe this marketing, the thick books. I believe marketing in few words. I don't believe in marketing in thick books, because I cannot pick it up, so how can I read it? Product strength is ultimate strength. Price marketing is ultimate marketing. And whisper publicity is ultimate publicity. What is word of mouth publicity people are saying? This thing I'm saying last 30 years. Product is ultimate innovation, because product makes the difference. Every product industry is service industry, and every service industry is product industry. Same time, every product industry and service industry are now IT industry. Because I tell you, three, four years before, my son told me we should take membership in NASCOM. I have requested them, can I get a membership in NASCOM? They said, no, you can't, you are a manufacturer product and all, you are not from IT. Now NASCOM want us to become their member, because every product industry without IT is not possible. They are saying now, if Google is a website, if Amazon is a website, if eBay is a website, Clubcard is also a website. So you are going to get the membership. Please take your membership. Packaging is part of product. I believe packaging is part of product. Packaging has to be that usable. Promotion by satisfaction and sell through omnichannel. Why omnichannel? Without offline, you cannot success in online. And same time, without online, you cannot grow and survive or sustain. Because e-commerce has now become the new driving force of growth of small and medium enterprises in India. And has been a major contribution to new job opportunities, all three sectors, postgraduate, graduate, and undergraduate. As per available data, the e-commerce sector in India is projected to cross 80 billion by 2020 and will account for 2.5% of India's GDP by 2030. Why I'm saying this? Because those who are delivery men giving the bikes or cycles, they are all undergraduate. Those, the second level is all graduate. And higher level, all are master's degree holder. They are all postgraduate. Entrepreneurship is the biggest social service. What I have seen, this is my last slide. Entrepreneurship is the biggest social service because people say, I want to become a social entrepreneur. People say, I want to do a social work. And I just love it. I said, how can you become a social entrepreneur being without entrepreneur? Suddenly we'll say, who has funding? Is funding become stopped? My company has become closed. My activity has been closed. So entrepreneurs are the biggest social service. Why? Entrepreneur has outperformed the innovation and actual art of living. But actually in our country, more NGO than school. Learn himself, entrepreneur, learn himself and protect others. Availability of essential commodities, whatever you see in the available in the market, all due to entrepreneur. Generate employment and develop skilled worker. Develop ancillary unit and create entrepreneur. Give revenue and earn foreign exchange. Support other industry by procurement and supply. And why? It is art of living. Living in the favorable or unfavorable situation is called part of living. And smiling in all those situations is art of living. Entrepreneur cannot get annoyed. Entrepreneur always has to smile, whatever the situation is. He has to smile, he cannot annoy it. If anybody says anything, he cannot react or anything like that. At last, I would like to tell you, if anybody interested to become a small entrepreneur or anybody has to join in digital marketing, I'm ready to give the support. If you ask me, what do you know about digital marketing? Entrepreneurship, yes. Whatever the small entrepreneur in your diversified product in the country, and you see the thousands of entrepreneurs have developed in UNDP project and Ministry of Textiles and all their statement. This is not my statement. And Vinod Gupta, IFT, all the committee, I'm there. But I tell you, if you ask me, what do you know about digital marketing? Have you ever purchased anything online? I will say no. I never purchased anything in online. Neither I know how to purchase in online. But if you ask me, have you ever sold anything online? I will say yes, more than 1 lakh pieces I have sold. And different type of problem I have faced and all being overcome. Thank you.
Thank you very much, Mr. Tarun. We request Mr. Sagar to share his views.
Hi friends, good afternoon. Okay, there's a small video on Wow Momo which I guess could be played before I start talking. Yeah. Start. Thank you. all saw this brief video on Wow Momo. But you know, today as I stand in front of you and I talk, this video has lost relevance for me because, you know, I was just sitting with Mr. Asif in the lunchroom. And he's someone who can't see. But you know, the way he uses technology, he's living his life. So, you know, we people use technology, but he's living technology. So, you know, more than seeing this video today, I want to dedicate my talk to him. And I want to really go down deep into my story and, you know, get started. I guess this is the last time I'm going to use this video today. Henceforward, you know, it's just going to be me and my story. So, Vinod and me started Wowmo with an investment of only 30,000 8 years back. Yes, my friend. 30,000 rupees 8 years back. We opened one small shop-in-shop kiosk inside Spencer's in Calcutta. We walked into the Spencer's office. They said, why should we give you space? You're not a brand. So my answer was, sir, every brand requires an opportunity to become a brand. Give me the opportunity, I'll create a brand. That's how we got started. Borrowed money from my dad. I remember when we opened our first store, we did not even have money to print leaflets. But what did we do? We believed in our product. So it was Vinod and me. Vinod used to stand inside the kiosk wearing a Wow Momo t-shirt, and I would be outside the kiosk wearing a Wow Momo t-shirt, and I would walk up to every customer. Hi, sir. Hi, ma'am. We've opened a new Momo kiosk called Wow Momo. We're doing sampling of Momos. You can taste one piece of Momo and see. We were confident about the product. We knew ki customer ek baar hamara Momo khayega, to he'll become ours forever. We did that for the first 6 months, and this Spencer was a very small Spencer store in Springdale in Tollikanj. Within 6 months, we actually captured the entire community by doing sampling and making them regular customers. Now that gave Spencer's the belief that, you know, these guys can do business. So from a small store where Spencer's would do a business of around a lakh a day, we would, from a 30 square feet space, end up doing a business of almost, you know, 7,000-8,000 rupees a day. So we were coming very close to 7-8% of the business from a 30 square feet. They gave us a store inside Spencer's in South City Mall. South City Mall, one of the best malls of the country, one of the best Spencer's, undoubtedly helped us to become a big brand. As we stand today, from a 90 square feet, we do a revenue of almost 10 lakhs a month. So this is how the entire journey began. Okay, we opened one store, saved money, opened another store, saved money, opened two more stores, bootstrapped, plowed back profits, that's what you call it. So when you're a startup, you know, 1 rupee saved is like 5 rupees earned, and that's what we believed in. I remember there was a day when Vinod and me would literally lift momos in our hands and walk 10 minutes to save 10 rupees of auto fare. We had to change two autos to come from Tollikens to Jadavpur. And as I stand today, we have a fleet of over 20 vehicles. We have an employee strength of over 900 people. Now, what is it that made us wow? Why is it that, you know, Wow Momo happened? In this room, how many of you people eat Wow Momo? If you can please raise your hands. Thank you so much. It's you people who made us wow. I mean, you need to have a good product and a good audience for that product. And you people have been the audience who've eaten us and appreciated us. So, you know, when we started Wow Momo, you would only get steam momos available in chicken or veg. We said, kuch alag karte hain. So we came up with prawn momos, we came up with paneer momos, we came up with mushroom momos. So we played with variants of steam momos. Then we said, let's do something innovative. So we came up with pan-fried momos, where we fry the momo in specially prepared sauces. We wanted to convert a momo into a meal, so we created the concept of a momo burger, where we stuff two pieces of fried momo between the burger breads. So, you know, you add 65 bucks to your momo, you get a Pepsi and a burger with it. We said, yeah, isko aur bada meal karna hai. We were going to newer cities like Bangalore and Delhi, where the real estate cost was very high. Now, to enable us to, you know, make a living and be profitable with this high real estate cost, we said we need to convert momo into a meal. So we came up with a concept of sizzler momos, where we serve six pieces of momo with rice or noodles. And, you know, it's highly priced, so it takes up your APC. Then we felt ki hamare menu mein koi dessert nahi hai. So came chocolate momo, okay, which is one of the hot favorites. Last year we moved into Delhi NCR, okay, where people really love tandoori stuff. So we came up with tandoori momos. We came up with a baked momo or gratin, which is like a lasagna. So you have a layer of pan-fried momo, white cream, noodles and cheese. All this that I'm saying, what did we do? We just did simple things with style. Humne koi rocket science nahi kiya. We just did simple things with style. We gave our brand a look and feel, a color, like Sir was saying. We created impression in the mind of the consumer to the look and feel of the brand, to what my guy wears as a t-shirt, to the kind of packaging that we have. It's very simple. You have to create an impression in the mind of the consumer from what you do. And that's what we did. We gave it a look and feel. We gave it a color. And it's very simple. Jo dikhta hai, wo bikta hai. You need to be seen. You need to show yourself. And that's what we did. So a simple product to a brand. This journey has had ups and downs. You know, I mean, we've seen good days, we've seen bad days. But, you know, just like you need to eat food every day to survive, we also had to get inspired every day. So, you know, when we as a promoter, as a startup, you tend to really market yourself amongst your consumers. You really tend to market yourself amongst other stakeholders. We in Wow Momo believe that the biggest strength for us is our team, you know. We've always, on first priority, marketed ourselves first amongst our employees. You know, one good employee can get you 10 more good employees. And if your employee is happy, if your employee has a smile on his face, the customer will have a smile on his face. If you have a kick-ass product, and if you give them kick-ass service, no one can stop you from becoming a brand. And that's what we did. So our employees have been our biggest strength, you know, right from one part-time chef who joined us at a 3,000 rupee salary when I started Wow Momo. You know, he would come early in the morning and make momos and go. Today, that same chef gets a salary of over 1.5 lakhs a month. He's just bought his own home of 50 lakhs. His daughter's going to an English medium school. So, you know, his lifestyle has changed. So if you really want to build a brand, okay, you need to really know how to share wealth. By wealth, I don't just mean, you know, money. I mean respect, position, growth. So, you know, if you need to make wealth, you need to know how to share wealth. And for us, we've been able to share this wealth with our team. I mean, I've always told my core team that, you know, my first 100 employees, first 100 managers and my first 1,000 employees are going to be my biggest strength and my biggest asset. If we can keep them with us, there's no looking back, you know. I mean, your foundation has to be strong. And by God's grace, we managed to do that. You know, today, our national business manager was a serving steward in Cafe Coffee Day. I handpicked him, and now he's there with us as a national business manager. I mean, from drawing a salary of 11,000 rupees to over 2 lakhs a month, that's called growth, you know. And when you give people this kind of growth, when you show them a dream, and when you give them live examples of this dream, that's how your company grows. So I think we've really managed to do that really well. Now, what is it that keeps me and Binod going? Well, our logic is very simple, you know. I mean, every morning when I wake up, it's a happy feeling that, you know, we have 900 people working with us, so 900 families. We want to make it 1,000, we want to make the 1,000, 2,000, we want to make the 2,000, 1 lakh a day, okay? As I stand here today, yesterday in Bangalore, we opened our 100th store. So we are really expanding at the speed, I mean, maybe higher than even the time I got to, you know, change this presentation, which said 80 stores. So, you know, the journey has been fabulous, fantastic, and it's all because of the team we have. And it's been because of the passion that the team has been able to deploy. And it's been because, you know, we've been inspired also from time and again. I mean, just like, you know, when you're hungry, you need to have food every day to survive. Today, when I met Asif, I was inspired for another 2-3 years to do something more bigger, more better. So as entrepreneurs, you know, you need to be inspired every day. You need to be an inspiration for others. You know, today, Binod and me, our aim is that, you know, by the time we are 50 years old, we should have 4 to 5 free cancer hospitals. And how are we going to do it? We're going to contribute 1 rupee every plate of momo sold towards that cause. And trust me, you know, if I can do it, and if 10 more people can follow me to do it, this country becomes a better place. And because 10 will follow them, and 10 will follow them. It's a chain, you know. It's absolutely a chain. You know, people talk about demonetization for the last two, three weeks, people have been asking me whenever I meet them, how has business been after demonetization, whether business has gone down or not, etc., etc. So I'll tell you how business has been, you know. For the first 4-5 days, we saw a dip in sales. Our sales were down by 40%, okay? It was affecting us, definitely. Then we said, kya kare? Let's do something again differently. So what we did, around every store of ours, okay, there are at least 4-5 ATMs. So we told our employees, let's take a nice, good-looking bag, fill it with water bottles, go to the ATM counters. People are standing in a huge queue. Let's serve them complimentary water, okay? Then they are hungry. Show them your menu card. They will give you order, and you will get your sales happening. Trust me, from a dip of 40% by doing this initiative, a very simple initiative, where from every store, people used to go to the ATM counters, serve water to people, give them the menu card, take orders, come over there in line, serve them the order, hot momos, and also give them a 20% discount by swiping their card through it. So we have these EDC machines, which are like GPRS ones. Again, the power of technology. Go there, swipe it, use it. From a 40% dip, we came down to a 16% dip. I mean, that's what you do to build a brand. That's what you have to do as an entrepreneur. You know, you just cannot, you need to learn to move with times. Okay? So if something good is happening, you cannot trip about it. You need to move ahead with times. And I think these small situations, you know, when you grab the best of opportunities in them, what did we do? We didn't do anything differently. I mean, we just used our minds and just gave the customer convenience. The customer wants pampering, the customer wants convenience. And you know, forget the fact, had we not even got business, the very fact that my staff was serving water to everyone, it was a feel-good factor for them, you know, ki hum kuch achha kar rahe hain. You know, every day when you wake up and sochte ho ki hum kuch achha kar rahe hain, it's a positive thing. And we all should always be positive. I think that's been our biggest strength, and I hope we continue to be positive. And the only thing I can tell you guys is that, you know, like I told Asif also today, there's a will, there's a way. If you cannot see light towards the end of the tunnel, don't give up, because that's not the end. You will see light at the end of the tunnel, because if there's a will, there's a way. You know, Javed Akhtar used to say these lines, ki agar, you know, manzile hai to mushkile hai to hausla hai to vishwas hai, kyunki fighter hamesha jeetta hai. It's a fact. If you're a fighter, you're bound to win. All the best. Thank you.
Hello.
Thank you, Mr. Sagar and Mr. Tarun.
Yeah.
Mr. Tarun, as per his experience, started sharing with a possibility of unemployment for today's youth. And Mr. Sagar ended it with lots of possibilities of employment by starting new Momo counters. So if there are any other inquiries for unemployed youth of India, please contact Mr. Sagar. There is an opportunity of tremendous growth over here. And there is a solution of Mr. Tarun's concern, what he started sharing, that if you are an entrepreneur, you will be successful. Don't look only for jobs or services or part-time things. Look something beyond what is your capacity. Can we have some questions for both the speakers? No questions? So everybody liked Momo? Sagarji, in your slide, if I'm not correct, or if correct me if I'm wrong, I have not seen Gujarat, and I belong to Gujarat, and we tend to be a business kind of people, although I don't belong to. So if you can give me a franchise in Gujarat. Company owned and company operated, so...
You're not really into franchising.
So hire me as your employee.
But yeah, definitely, you know, the reason that we are not doing too many cities is very simple. It's a business logic to it, you know. We feel that we are the kings of Calcutta today. We want to make Delhi, Bangalore as strong as we're in Calcutta. So, you know, it's about consolidation. It's about, you know, doing less cities, but believing in not really believing in quantity, but believing in quality in those cities. So today, like, we can, you know, demand our name in Calcutta. We want to do the same thing in Bangalore and Delhi, and it's beginning to happen. So I think that's when business really works well, you know, because it's very good to say that, you know, and a very feel-good factor that you're a pan-India chain. But, you know, to become that strong, you need to give it time. So Domino's, before they went IPO, they were there only in 13 cities. And after going IPO, today they're in 240 cities. So that's the difference.
In Gujarati, we say that Mareshu and Tareshu. That means, Mera kya aur aapka kya. Aapne meri nahi suni, but main aapke faide ke liye ek baat batata hoon. Ki aap khaman momos, patra momos aur fafda momos bhi bana sakte Gujarat mein aake.
Zarur sir, zarur.
और जब भी आप बनाएंगे और जो भी प्रॉफिट होगा वो मेरी ओर से आपकी चैरिटी में मेरी ओर से आप ले लीजिएगा
थैंक यू
सर यू स्पोक अबाउट लॉट ऑफ थिंग्स ऑन मार्केटिंग एंड द सोशल वेबसाइट्स एंड कपल ऑफ अदर थिंग्स लॉट मेनी स्पीकर्स इन दिस टू थ्री डेज हैव बीन टॉकिंग अबाउट सोशल मीडिया एंड कपल ऑफ अदर थिंग्स जस्ट सम एग्जाम्पल बियॉन्ड फेसबुक एंड व्हाट्सएप वॉट इज सोशल मार्केटिंग एंड हाउ कैन दे हैव देयर careers in their future?
See, basically, I don't have any bookish knowledge. Whatever I said and whatever I do is from my practical experience. I'm basically a bootstrap entrepreneur. I don't have any loan or something, any cash credit.
Closer.
Cash credit or anything like that. See, basically, we had an All India dealer network. From Kashmir to Kanyakumari. After the globalization, liberalization happened, slowly all being closed because of Chinese fake brand, then Amazon, Delsey, all these, Samsonite, Delsey, all these came. And once upon a time, we become a second largest brand in after VIPs, aristocrats and all, in soft luggage is concerned. Then where after Duckback and all. After this Amazon came, this Flipkart came, I find it the one dealer is covering entire country. And I'm straightway giving the product to the customer directly. Same time we have our own stores also, my own online stores. The Facebook, the LinkedIn and all, the people are getting aware of this, you have a site, this, that, everything. But ultimately people will buy whatever the best product, the best price. And I always say, ultimate customers market the product. If anybody buy a product, if he's happy, he will say 10%. The Facebook, the LinkedIn, all these things, I believe in like that only. And like Mr. Murthy yesterday said, the word of mouth publicity, the big company doesn't do this, that. I fully agree with him. Because if product strength is there and price marketing is there, automatic whisper publicity is going to be like, I can give you the example. In our time, the Ganeshji Doodh Pira, it's become a viral. As long product had life, that long people are spending money. STD counter, they're going, Ganeshji Doodh Pira, daughter is calling mother,